Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I went to my library's book sale yesterday and made out. My library has sales quite often and I always seem to miss them, but this time I actually looked up when the sales were going to be and wrote them down on my calendar, and so I was able to go the first day of the sale for this one particular library. There's another library that's kind of close to me that's having their sale the first week of April. And I'm definitely going to go to that library and check out the books that they have there because this was so great. It was like the best treasure hunt ever. So let me just go ahead and get into the books that I got. This first one I'm going to show is called Killing Floor by Lee Child. And it's the first book in the Jack Reacher series. I believe this is a TV show too, or maybe a movie series. I can't remember, but it's definitely a name I've heard of, Jack Reacher. But basically he is a former military policeman who is now a drifter. He ends up in a small southern town in Georgia and gets accused of murder. He didn't do it, but he has to prove his innocence. Stephen King wrote on here. I thought that was kind of a funny blurb, so I'm gonna read what Stephen King wrote. Or at least somebody representing Stephen King, because who knows who actually writes these blurbs anymore. But it says that this book wins the award for best corrupt southern town in a summer novel with best exploding warehouse. So yeah, I am excited to read this. This next one is called Cycle of the Werewolf by Stephen King. This one, it's not a graphic novel, but it definitely has illustrations in it. So it's, I guess it's werewolf stories in general. I don't know if it follows one in particular werewolf or different werewolves, but I do know the movie Silver Bullet, which is one of my favorite movies ever, is based off of at least a story out of here. And I feel like I just watched somebody talk about this and I'm having a hard time remembering who it was, but it was either Joanie Reads or Carol Marie Reads. One of them, or maybe both of them, I don't remember, but I know somebody was just talking about this book. So yeah, I was really excited that I saw it at the library. Oh, and I just wanted to add that all the paperback books were only a dollar. So I will continue on with the other paperbacks I got. This next one is The Girl Who Loved Tom Gordon by Stephen King. I've never read this one, and I think this is a movie as well. I really know nothing about it, but I heard good things, so for a dollar, I thought I would definitely pick it up. The next one is Salem's Lot. I actually read this book 2 years ago and I loved it, but I listened to it on Audible and I didn't actually own the book. So I'm very happy that I now own my own copy because I really, really loved this story. This next one is Carrie. I've seen the movie and it's not one of my favorites. It's just not a storyline that I particularly enjoy, but I don't own the book, so I'm trying to collect the Stephen King books that I don't already own, so I went ahead and picked it up. Then I got the Bachman books from Stephen King as well, and this is 4 books in 1, so it's very chunky, but it has Rage, The Long Walk, which is a book I already own, Roadwork, and The Running Man. I haven't actually read any of these books, so yeah, I'm looking forward to getting into this. This is one I know Carol Marie Reads did read. I remember her talking about this a lot, and I don't think she was a big fan of the Bachman books, but I definitely want to give it a try and see how it goes. Okay, now on to the hardbacks. I got Dolores Claiborne by Stephen King. As you can see, there's a trend here. They had a lot of Stephen King books at this sale, so I really lucked out. And this happens to be a first edition copy. I did some research and I looked it up last night, so yeah, that is very exciting. I've never read this book, but I did see the movie. It has Kathy Bates in it. She's one of my favorite actresses. So yeah, I don't know when I'm going to get to this one, but I'm glad I have it. I grabbed the Tommyknockers. This is one that I know Jason White has read recently, and I think he said it was like okay, but not his favorite. This one is alien related or has something to do with aliens in it. Again, I saw this movie many years ago. I don't really remember it and I've never read the book, but I'm definitely into aliens. So yeah, it's another one I'm really happy to have. And it's another first edition copy. So yes. Also, all the hardbacks that I got were $2.50. Now this one I think I'm most excited for. It's The Dark Half by Stephen King. This one is set in Castle Rock, and I just read Needful Things with Cami for Cami's Harrowing Horror Book Club, and that book is also set in Castle Rock, and a lot of the stories are intertwined. This one in particular has the cop in it from Needful Things, so I definitely will be reading this one soon because I loved Castle Rock, and I really am looking forward to getting back into that crazy town. Oh, also another first edition. So I really scored. Man, I love my library. I love it so much. Okay, on to non-Stephen King. I picked up The Lost World by Michael Crichton. I apparently already own this in paperback, but didn't realize that till I got home. But yeah, for $2.50, you can't go wrong with a hardcover of this book. Plus, I really like the cover. Moving on to some other type of books, some historical books. This is The Witches, Salem 1692 by Stacy Schiff. This is obviously all about the Salem witch trials. I've heard amazing things about this. I know this one is really well researched and really well done. So yeah, I love things to do with the Salem witch trials. It's just a very fascinating, crazy time. And so yeah, I was very happy to find this book because I was actually going to pay full price for this book recently at Barnes & Noble, I think, is where I saw it. And I put it back down and thought, no, I don't like paying full price for anything. I'll wait. And $2.50. I grabbed this historical fiction novel. It's called The Last Days of Night by Graham Moore. This is about the fight about getting electricity going. And the court case between Thomas Edison and George Westinghouse has a lot to do with Nikola Tesla. Again, this is an incredibly fascinating time in our history. Moving on to some science fiction, I grabbed Robopocalypse by Daniel H. Wilson. This is an AI story. I think it's like dystopian AI where machines start coming to life and taking over. Since I'm starting to get into science fiction right now, I was excited to find this one. Have no idea if it's any good or not, but I really hope it is. Okay, back to paperbacks. These were sitting behind me and I didn't notice them. I grabbed Mindhunter. There we go. Inside the FBI's Elite Serial Crime Unit by John Douglas and Mark Olshacker. This is one that, again, I almost bought and paid full price for at Books A Million, like 2 weeks ago. I had this, I was walking around with it in the store, and I put it back because I didn't want to spend that much money. So I found it in paperback for a dollar. This is basically one of the FBI agents that are in the Silence of the Lambs books. It's based off of this real person who solved all of these crazy serial killer crime things. But yeah, this is like his real life story, or you know, stories about the crimes that he's dealt with, and there's pictures in here. It's also a TV show which I'm planning on watching soon, but I haven't started yet. But yeah, I was thrilled to find this for $1. And the last one I picked up has to have the most bizarre premise that I've ever seen, and I'm so excited for it. I'm like all about this. It's called The Complete Werewolf by Anthony Butcher, and it has Masters of Horror written on it. So I'm like, oh cool, a horror book with a werewolf. I like werewolves. But when I read the back, this is what it said. I'm just going to read you the small little blurb because I can't put words to it. It says, this blend of horror, science fiction, and fantasy represents a rich display of the best short fiction by award-winning author Anthony Butcher. The Complete Werewolf is peopled by interplanetary predators, rebellious androids, desert-dwelling mutants, doppelgangers, and, of course, the famous professor, Wolf Wolf, an inspired and all-devouring individual bent on possessing Gloria, his favorite student. It sounds so ridiculous. I'm just so ready to dive into this. You have no idea. So yeah, that is all of the books that I got yesterday at my library book sale. Cannot wait to go to the other library next week and see what they have. Yeah, treasure hunting is the best. I absolutely love it. Oh, there's a cat in there. So yeah, like I said, definitely let me know if you've read any of these books, if you've got opinions on which ones I should get to sooner rather than later. I would love to know. I hope you all have a great weekend, and I will see y'all later. Bye.